Hello and welcome to another car review. This is the 2020 Hyundai Reina. The Hyundai Reina is the newest entry-level car of Hyundai, at least for the Philippine market, after nilang i-cancel ang Hyundai Ion noong 2019. It is manufactured in China, but it's still a Hyundai. And this is the kind of car you're considering if you are looking at something like the Suzuki Desire, the Mitsubishi Mirage, which is way more expensive, the Kia Soluto, which is also at some point is a Hyundai. Yes, because Hyundai owns 33% of Kia shares. Dati 50% yun. Nag-declare kasi ang Kia nung 1997 ba yun? 98 ng bankruptcy. Then Hyundai bought 50%. But on 2018, it's 33%. Something like that. Kaya kung mapapansin nyo sa mga Kia and Hyundai, they share the same parts. At sa video na ito, we're going to talk about the Reina's design. We're going to have a tour of the interior and I will tell you how it drives. Surprisingly, it's good. Hyundai Reina is based on Hyundai's fluidics culture design, means flowing lines. So, well, kita naman sa Reina, sa hood, maraming lines. Sa doors, marami rin. The front to me looks like it's a mix of calm and aggressive. But sometimes, sa malayo, I mistakenly think that I am looking at a pinakagustong-gusto ko dito sa side ay itong sa may running board. You don't see this line often sa running board. Mostly, flat lang yan. But on Hyundai Reina, it's like that. Sa likod naman, it's very simple. Flat lang yung trunk. The registration plate is on the bumper. Pero yung likod, kamukha ni Kia Soluto. Well, once inside, it's all black. Binasag lang nitong silver accents dito sa may aircon vents, with line all the way to the other side of the aircon vents. Also dito sa may driver side aircon vents, may silver accent din siya. The door opener, silver accent. The seats is covered with two-tone fabric, but it's very comfortable. Saka yung bolstering niya dito sa body, mataas. Yakap na yakap ako. Dito sa loob, it's very practical. Napakaraming pockets. Meron dito sa ilalim ng aircon controls. Meron kang two cup holders dito. And at the back of the cup holders, meron na namang pocket. Door pockets are pretty big. Meron ding bottle holders sa door pocket. And the door handle, pwede ring pocket. Kasi nga, wala siyang butas. Ang kakaiba dito sa door card sa harapan, wala dito yung window switches, which will I talk about in a minute. Aircon controls has 3 knobs, napakadaling intindihin. And above that, nandito yung AM/FM radio mo with Bluetooth for your cellphone and your audio. Well, a touchscreen infotainment is optional with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay for millennials. But that will set you back 50,000 pesos. Are you willing to pay 50,000 pesos for that infotainment system? Silence means no. The gauge cluster is very luminous, kahit maliwanag. With LCD display in the middle that displays your fuel gauge, engine temperature, your trip computer, your odometer. The window controls is below the climate control, which reminds me of the R35 Nissan GT-R driving mode controls. But on this one, it's for the windows. Meron ka ring dome light, map light, vanity mirror dito sa sun visor for the passenger only. The driver, wala. Mirror switch, nandito dito sa gilid, sa kaliwa. And what about headlight leveler? Huh? I'm sure your Mirage doesn't have that. Sa likod naman, it's also comfortable. The floor is almost flat, kaya sitting in the middle is not a problem. Yun nga lang, door pockets are not as generous like on the front. Kasi nga, yung window switches is already there, unlike on the front. It's also very spacious at the back. This is my comfort seating position. Here's my space. My knee room is very big. I can also straight my legs somehow. Trunk capacity is 475 liters, which is way more than the competitor. Factory mag wheels is not available on all trims sa Reina, which is meh. Kaya yung owner is planning to buy mag wheels. Everything is hard plastic. The dashboard, yung door cards. Well, of course, you're not buying a luxury or premium car. So, that's expected. Under the hood is a 1.4 liter naturally or normally aspirated petrol engine. It produces 93 brake horsepower with 13.5 kilograms of torque at 4,000 RPM. Actually, itong engine na to is based on Kappa. Kappa engine ng Hyundai. Matagal na engine na yan, from Hyundai i10 pa lang. Yung 3-cylinder, Kappa yon. The Hyundai Ion, Kappa rin yon. Tamang alaga, regular change oil. I think it will be reliable. Driving the Reina, it's surprisingly good. Responsive yung throttle. Although this is the 4-speed automatic, yung brake pedal has solid feel, which is really really good. Sarap apakan, matigas siya sa ibabaw. Pero hindi siya bitey. Throttle pedal, light pressure, hindi naman sobrang lambot. Tama lang. Sarap din apakan. Steering wheel is very light. Isang mga electronic power steering. Madalas malambot. Saka yung mga Hyundai, yan, sobrang lambot ng steering wheel. Pero it's very responsive. Well, turning radius is very very good, as I shall now demonstrate. Oh, diba? Driving visibility is very good. Yung mga side mirrors niya, malaki naman, kitang-kita ko naman. Yung window sa likod, tama lang, pero medyo maliit na pag nitingnan ko siya dito sa rear view mirror. Ang medyo hindi ko lang gusto, yung transmission is not that responsive kapag naka-automatic ka lang. Kailangan mong laro-laruin yung pedal mo, kailangan mong ibaon-baon yung pedal mo para mag-downshift siya. And on this turn, it leans. Mas na-enjoy ko siyang i-downshift kapag gamit ko yung shift lever. Oh. Kesa dun sa nilalaro-laro ko yung pedal, minsan parang ayaw niya mag-downshift eh. Suspension damping, okay naman siya. Hindi siya yung matalbog na ano. Komportable naman. May bounce kang mararamdaman, pero actually normal lang naman yun sa mga sedan mostly. Pero komportable naman siya. Hindi naman siya talbog pagod. Let's try overtaking. Second gear. Okay naman, may passing power naman siya. Driving safety, meron kong seatbelt, front, tatlo sa likod, driver and passenger airbags, and anti-lock braking system or ABS for 698,000 pesos. You can get this. Wala kang Android Auto or Apple CarPlay infotainment system, you need to add 50,000 pesos more to get that. 5-speed manual, mas mura. No mag wheels. That's the Hyundai Reina. I hope this video will be informative for you. I will see you again on the next car reviews, nonsense vlogs, and many, many more. And bye-bye!